Now that we know about direction fields, we can go back and look at Euler's method and draw pictures of what was happening. So remember, our example was we're taking the derivative of a function as 0.06 times the function, and the initial value is 1,000. We want to know what is the value when x equals 1 or when x equals 1. Okay? And our so-so estimate was to say, oh yeah, it's changing at a rate of 60 and it's going for time 1, so the change will be 60. And we'll wind up at 1,060. Now what's happening here is, here we are at 1,000, and our direction field told us that the slope was 60. And all we did is we took that and went in a straight line till we reached the point 1. And in fact, the actual curve does have a slope of 60 there, but it curves upwards. So we missed all of the curving. It gave us the right direction. We took a linear approximation. We followed the direction field, and it took us out here. Now, a better estimate was to do it in two steps, to compound our interest twice a year. And what that meant is that we had our slope of 60, and we followed in a straight line to 1/2, and then we reevaluated. Then we said, oh, the slope here isn't 60, it's actually 61.8. So now we better take a slight turn and go a different direction. We followed that different direction up until we're at 1. Now the real curve curves away, and so not only did we miss the curvature here, but at this point we were on the wrong track. We had the wrong value at 1/2. Because we had the wrong value, our formula gave us the wrong derivative, and so we continue to have some more error up here. But even so, using the wrong derivative here is better than using the derivative here. Doing it in one step took us out here. Doing it in two steps took us there. It's not as good as doing the continuum, but all we're doing is we're following the direction field for a distance 1/2 and then consulting our GPS. The differential equation is like a GPS, and wherever you are, it tells you what direction you're supposed to be going. You check your GPS and it tells you, oh, you're supposed to be going this way, and then you follow it for another 1/2 year. Better still is to do things in steps, in smaller steps. If the curve looks like that, then when you take a small step of only 1/10 of a year, you're pretty darn close. And so your new derivative is also going to be pretty darn close. And your new derivative is going to be pretty darn close to the exact answer. And in the end, you don't wind up getting the exact answer, but you get very, very, very close. You wind up with, 1,061.6 when you should have gotten 1,061.8, but that's doing very well. The smaller the step size, the more you're hugging the true trajectory, the better your estimates for the derivatives are, and the more accurate your result is. In other words, if you want to get where you're going, consult your GPS more often, not less often. So, in general, the idea is, for Euler's method, is you have a differential equation, and you have a starting point, and you pick a small increment to step forwards. And every step, you follow the direction field a distance h to the right. So you start at x naught, and the direction field says the slope is supposed to be f of x naught y naught. So you're here, and you just follow, here's the direction field, and you follow it in a straight line until you get to a particular spot, x1, and the corresponding value you call y1. And then you consult your direction field. You say, oh, the direction field at this spot is something different. You figure out the direction field at that spot is f of x1, y1, has a slope of f of x1, y1. And then you follow that direction field. Until you get to the value x2, and now we're here we are at y2, and you keep on going, one step at a time. Every step, this is the slope given by the direction field. You follow the direction field out to get to your next point. Then find the new direction field, follow that direction field out to get to the next point, and keep on going. So in general, you go from one point to the next point by going a distance h sideways and h times the slope upwards. In other words, the new x is the old x plus h, the new y is the old y plus h times the slope given by the direction field.